Hey, what's going on, guys? So this is just a quick first impressions video of the BlackBerry Playbook. So I'm pretty much just recording this right off of the Playbook with the front-facing camera. It is a 3 megapixel sensor, shoots 1080p, so this will be recorded and uploaded in 1080p. You can actually upload stuff directly to a website. So for example, you have a picture and you want to post it to Twitter, you can just go into the web browser, go to twitter.com, and upload it right there, which is one of the very impressive things that I found out about the BlackBerry Playbook. So I guess we can start hardware-wise. The back of the Playbook feels very nice in the hands. It's not too heavy, but it is a little bit thicker than some other tablets. Let's see the screen. The screen is a pretty high-resolution screen for the size, but it's not, you know, the highest in the market. But of course, it is a year-and-a-half-old tablet. So you have to kind of excuse it for that. Let's see, web browser. The web browser is one of the other very impressive things with the flash support, things like that. Cameras, you know, they're pretty good. They're not autofocus, so things aren't going to be completely in focus. I'm not sure about how the microphone sounds, so hopefully you can hear me pretty well. I'm sure the camera, for sure. I don't know about the microphone, is better than the iPad 2s, but we'll have to go and test out the microphone. I'm sure the camera's a lot better. People always complain about the power button right on the top of the Playbook, but honestly, it's not really that bad. It's not really recessed as people are talking about how it is. I don't know, my fingers are pretty small. I'm just 16 years old. I don't have really chubby fingers or anything. It's not that hard to press, so I don't know if they changed something recently or to the Playbook, but it's not that bad. It does take some getting used to finding it, so you know, going up here and pressing the circle button. There is also the volume rocker and the play pause button at the top. People might not really realize the play pause button and like its advantages, but once you actually use it, it's very nice to use. You get used to it pretty quickly. And it's one of those things that you realize that it's nice to have. Really not necessary. I mean, there's always on-screen controls and stuff like that. But having a physical hardware button for that, it's very nice. Let's see here. The setup wasn't that bad. The process of turning it on, booting it up, that took a few minutes, which was kind of scary, but you know, it's working now, it's going good, so I'm pretty happy with it. So make sure you guys subscribe for the review. I'll have a separate video going over the cameras, how well they perform, things like that, and better lighting and all that stuff. So you know, make sure you look out for that. But anyways, I think that's it for this video. It's been about 3.5 minutes, so yeah, I'll see you guys later. Make sure you guys subscribe, and tell me what you think of this camera. If you think it's pretty good for the lighting right here, I just have a lamp right in front of me. So tell me what you think, and I'll see you guys later. Alright, so actually viewing the file right on my computer right here, I just noticed it's 720p. I did forget to change the settings, so I'm sorry. I'll have a separate video, as I talked about, going up pretty soon, so you guys make sure you subscribe for that. And yeah, so see you later.